In this video, we're going to finish our angle addition postulate worksheet on the KutaSoftware website. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free geometry worksheet. So we're going to start where you left off with number 11. Number 11 says, the measure of angle HGF equals 16x plus 4. So HGF equals 16x plus 4. The measure of angle EGF is 110. So here's angle EGF, and that's going to be 110 degrees. And the measure of angle HGE equals 3x plus 11. HGE is 3x plus 11. So from the angle addition postulate, we know that the measure of angle HGF equals the measure of angle EGF plus the measure of angle HGE. And that's because E is an interior point of HGF. So the measure of angle HGF is 16x plus 4. The measure of angle EGF is 110 degrees. And the measure of angle HGE is 3x plus 11. And we're solving for that x. So I'm going to subtract 3x and I'm going to subtract 11 from the right hand side. Whatever I do to the right, I have to do to the left. So 16x minus 3x is going to give me 13x, and then 4 minus 11 is going to give me a negative 7. And that is all going to be equal to 110 degrees. My next step, I'm going to add 7 to both sides. In doing so, I'll get that 13x equals 117. So I'm going to divide 13 from both sides to get that x is equal to 117 divided by 13, which is 9. So x equals 9 is my answer in number 11. In number 12, we have the measure of angle VUT. So that larger angle is equal to 175 degrees. Those two smaller angles, angle VUJ and angle JUT, will make up that 175 degrees. So if we add the measure angle VUJ, which is 17x minus 3, if we add that to the measure of angle JUT, which is 17x plus 8, we will get that total angle, which is 175 degrees. So now let's solve. We have 175, and then let's combine like terms. 17x plus 17x is 34x. And then since this 3 is subtracted, we can think of it as a negative. So negative 3 plus 8 is going to be a positive 5. Then we'll subtract 5 from both sides to get that 170 equals 34x. When we divide both sides by 34, 170 divided by 34 equals 5. So 5 is the value of x in number 12. In number 13, the measure of angle FCD is x plus 41. So I'll have x plus 41, and I have to add that to the measure of angle BCF. That's going to be x plus 78. When I add those two smaller angles together, I'll get the measure of the largest angle, angle BCD, which is given as 95 degrees. Simplifying, combining the x's, I'll get 2x, and then 41 plus 78 is 119. And that is equal to 95. Now when I subtract 119 from both sides, I'll get that 2x is equal to negative 24. When I divide both sides by 2, I'll get that x is equal to negative 12. Since negative 24 divided by 2 is 12, 2 divided by 2 is 1, 1 times x is x. In number 14, I'm finding x if the measure of angle BJK, this angle, so one of the smaller angles, is 146 plus 2x. So I'm going to have to add that smaller angle to the other smaller angle, angle IJB, which they say is 2x plus 26. So I'm going to add that to 2x plus 26. Those two smaller angles should add up to be the large angle, angle IJK, which is 172 degrees. And that is because B is interior of angle IJK. So combining like terms, 2x plus 2x is 4x, and 146 plus 26 is 172. And that is all equal to 172. When I subtract 172 from both sides, I get that 4x equals 0. When I divide both sides by 4, 0 divided by any number is 0, so x is equal to 0. In number 15, we're given that the measure of angle GFZ is 38 degrees. The measure of angle ZFE is 2x plus 125. And then finally, we're given that the larger angle, angle GFE, is equal to x plus 163. So when I write this out, I'll say x plus 163, the larger angle, equals the smaller angle of 38 degrees plus the other of 2x plus 125. Simplifying this, I'll get that x plus 163 equals 38 plus 125, which is 163 plus 2x. I'm going to subtract x on the left-hand side, and whatever I do to the left, I'll do to the right. And in the same step, I'm going to subtract 163. Now notice that 163 will cancel out on the right, and it will also cancel out on the left. So I'll be left with 0 on the left, and 2x minus x equals x. So 0 is my solution in number 15. In number 16, I'm finding x if the measure of angle LMN is 135 degrees. So LMN is 135 degrees, and that's going to be equal to the measure of angle LMV, which is negative 1 plus 45x, added to the measure of angle VMN, which is 23x. 135 equals negative 1 plus 45x plus 23x is 68x. I'm going to add 1 to both sides to get that 136 equals 68x. When I divide by 68, I know that 68 goes into 136 two times, so 2 equals x in number 16. In number 17, we're switching things up a bit. As opposed to finding or solving for x, we're finding the measure of an angle. So our answers now are going to be in degrees. So we're finding the measure of angle HIW. If the measure of angle WIJ is 10x and the measure of HIJ is 145 degrees and the measure of HIW is 2x plus 13. So in order to solve this, we have to find what x is and then plug x in for the measure of angle HIW, this equation here, to see what that measure is. So the largest angle we know is 145 degrees. So 145 equals 10x plus the measure of angle HIW, which is 2x plus 13. Simplifying this, we'll have 145 equals 10x plus 2x is 12x plus 13. Subtracting 13 from both sides, we'll get that 132 equals 12x. In order to solve for x, we'll divide by 12. 12 times 11 is 132, so 11 is equal to x. Now that we know what x is, we're taking 11 and plugging it in for the x in our equation for the measure of angle HIW, because that's what we need to solve for. So the measure of angle HIW w equals 2x plus 13. So the measure of angle HIW equals 2 times 11 plus 13. That's going to be 2 times 11, which is 22, plus 13. So our final answer, the measure of HIW is equal to 22 plus 13, which is 35 degrees. In number 18, we're going to do the same concept we did in number 17. We're going to solve for x and then plug that x value in to the equation of the angle we need to solve for. So we're trying to solve for the measure of angle ABC. So eventually we're going to use this equation, 17x plus 8, to get our final solution. For now, however, angle ABC is our larger angle. So 17x plus 8 equals the measure of angle ABK, which is 42 degrees, plus the measure of angle KBC, which is 12x minus 4. Simplifying this, we'll get 17x plus 8 equals 12x plus 38. I'm going to subtract an 8 from the left-hand side, so that will cancel out on the left. But at the same time, I'm going to subtract 12x from both sides as well, so that there is no longer an x on my right-hand side. 17x minus 12x equals 5x, and that's going to be equal to 38 minus 8, which is 30. When you divide both sides by 5, we get that x is equal to 6. Remember, I need to plug this value of 6 in for x to solve for the measure of angle ABC. So the measure of angle ABC equals 17x plus 8. That's equal to 17 times 6 plus 8. 17 times 6 is equal to 102. So I have 102 plus 8. When I add those together, I get 110 degrees. So 110 degrees is my solution in number 18. And that's the measure of angle ABC. In number 19, I have the measure of angle ZHG as 11x minus 1. I also have the measure of angle IHZ as 24. And the total measure of IHG is equal to 12x plus 13, and I'm solving for IHG. So I'll have 12x plus 13 equal to 11x minus 1 plus 24. The largest angle equals the two smaller angles since Z is an interior point. So I'll have 12x plus 13, and that's equal to 11x plus 23. I'll subtract 11x from both sides, so that my x's on the right will cancel out. And in order to isolate the x, I'll subtract 13 from the left. Whatever I do to the left, I have to do to the right. So 12x minus 11x equals x, and that's going to be equal to 23 minus 13, which is 10. So we have that x equals 10. However, we're not solving for x, we're solving for the measure of IHG. So we're going to take 10 and plug that in to the equation for IHG. So the measure of angle IHG equals 12 times 10 plus 13. 12 times 10 is 120, and we're adding 13 to that, so our final solution is 133 degrees. And that's the measure of angle IHG. And lastly, number 20. Let's solve for x to start. We have the measure of angle GFN as 4x plus 10. We're going to add that to the other small angle, angle NFE, which is 14x plus 3. And that's going to equal the largest angle, angle GFE, which is 157. Combining like terms, 4x plus 14x is 18x, and then we're going to add that to 10 plus 3, which is 13. Subtract 13 from both sides to get that 18x equals 144. When I divide both sides by 18, 18 divided by 18 is 1, 1 times x is x, 144 divided by 18 equals 8. So x represents the value 8. However, since I'm finding the measure of angle in FE, I'm going to plug that 8 into the equation for the measure of angle in FE. So we have the measure of angle in FE, and that's equal to 14x plus 3, but we know x is 8, so 14 times 8 plus 3. 14 times 8 is 112, and we're adding 3 to 112. That will give us 115 as our final solution for this worksheet. As always, please remember to subscribe to my channel and like this video. Also, comment if you need further clarification on any of these problems.